It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
All right, welcome back. Now, when we kind of jumped off right there, I was, of course, breaking down what action we did get to have come our way in the Group B yesterday in the Africa Cup of Nations. And quickly, I'll mention the fixtures that we have today. Morocco up against Ivory Coast, very interesting fixture, as well as, of course, Togo versus the DR Congo. Like I told you, all teams still have a chance to qualify, but that maybe we shall be getting into a little bit later when we get to indulge my friend here, Peter Okwoche from the BBC. They are down here in Uganda for a week-long broadcast, live broadcast that started last night. And how is that going for you, Peter?
It's going fantastically well. I mean, Ugandans have been very receptive of us, which is just so great to see. And our production yesterday, I mean, we just thought that we would bring our program, which normally we broadcast from London, but wanted to bring it to the people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we just looked at the African map and said, where are we going to? Well, we'll go to the country we love the most, Uganda.
Right. Someone else is watching and they're not from Uganda, and they must be feeling like, why do they love Uganda more?
It could be coming to your city next, so don't be too jealous.
All right. It's just that they won't love you as much as they love Uganda. They started here. Anyhow, this is going to be going on for a week. What exactly are we broadcasting? Stories from Uganda, or is it the normal program with stories from Eritrea and wherever in Uganda?
It's going to be a mix of both of them, because we are in Uganda now, we're doing a lot more Uganda stories. So I've been out today doing some Ugandan stories. I did some yesterday that are going to run on the program. But, you know, because it's a news program, we'll also report on the news. We've got some very hard-hitting investigations that we've carried out that we're going to be running on the program as well. So it's going to be, you know, quite a mix of different things. But because we have a live audience as well, so lots of Ugandans taking part live on set, you know, it's just been great.
All right, and yesterday we did see Cindy Sanyu, the Ugandan musician,
Absolutely.
On there. So everyone is covered. Now, BBC Focus on Africa airs at 8:30 p.m. on BBC. Mm-hmm. If you get to have that in Uganda. And for us at Urban Television, we have it running for you at 9 p.m. So make it a point to get to catch the one tonight if you missed out on yesterday.
Absolutely.
Peter, let's talk about you. News anchor, celebrated news anchor on BBC.
You're too kind.
that's what we look at down here in Uganda. And you also do the mainstream news. What is your story?
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, let me confess today, I'm actually just a radio DJ. You know, that's how I started my career in journalism.
Okay.
And then, you know, I just moved up through the ranks. But I'm more of a news journalist. I just have an affinity for sports. You know, okay. I like sports, and you know, every once in a while, given the opportunity to report on sports, you know, I just grab it because I think sports is good. The way we report sports has become so static. You know, people go to these competitions and they say stories behind the competition.
Cool.
You know,
yes.
How the fans are following it. You know, how it's impacting on the country that is hosting a competition.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's the kind of sports I like to do.
All right.
You know, yeah.
Interesting. I guess we do share something in there because I, on the other hand, privileged to head the news department at the station, but love
there
to
you
do
go. Yeah.
The sport. And
absolutely.
This is what I do on air.
Absolutely.
Great stuff.
Yeah.
So, your story, how do we... You do say that you started out as a radio DJ.
Yeah, so I started as a radio DJ in Nigeria a long time ago, nearly 25 years ago. I'm
All
so
right.
old now.
Ah.
You know, nearly 25 years ago, straight out of university. And, you know, just grew up through the ranks. After a while, I took a break from broadcasting, went into publishing, magazine publishing, was a writer for a magazine.
Still in Nigeria?
In Nigeria. Yeah. Did that for about 6 years, 5 years, and then went back into broadcasting again.
Mm-hmm.
And 2 years later the BBC came knocking and picked me from Nigeria and took me to London. So I've been with the BBC now for 12 years.
All right.
Started off on BBC Radio World Service. Mm-hmm. And then moved to Focus on Africa when we started the program 5 years ago.
All right.
Yeah.
12 years, quite the spell down there.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you do come, of course, to Africa at about the time the Africa Cup of Nations is going on. At about the time, Uganda are at the Africa Cup of Nations, or were, considering we've been knocked out at the Africa Cup of Nations for the first time.
Still got one more game left.
Yeah, one more game to play for our pride, probably,
yes,
or something like that. What did you see of Uganda that you will take home?
Do you know what? I mean, the fact that you were even able to qualify for the first time in 39 years. Don't forget, you know, what people forget is that the last time you played at the Nations Cup, you played in the finals.
Yeah.
You know, you played in the finals. I think it was against Ghana also.
Yeah.
You know, and you lost that narrowly. But it took a long time for this team to go back. So I think going back in its in the first place is such a huge achievement that Ugandans should be very proud of. Mm-hmm. You know, if you go around the continent and look at the countries that didn't qualify for it, you know what I mean? Nigeria, my country, mm-hmm. you know, three-time champions, you know, always qualifying for the semifinals at least. We didn't make it this time.
At the CAF Awards, you have the most promising player, yeah, the
youngest player, you know, I mean, so we've got great talent. Look at South Africa, you know, I mean, just a few years ago, they were hosting the World Cup. They didn't qualify. Angola hosted in, was it in 2010?
Yeah.
And didn't qualify. You know, look at Zambia. Yeah. 2012 champions, they didn't qualify. You know, so I think the Cranes should be very proud of themselves. I tell you what, you know, I was going to make it a secret, but I'm going to open it on your program. Tomorrow, I will be wearing a Cranes jersey,
all
you
right.
know, to support the team. I think Coach Micho has done very well. I think it's now left for, you know, business to invest in football. Mm-hmm. That's the only way to grow business. Government is not going to come into it.
All right.
So business invests in football, grassroots football especially. Catch them young and train them hard, so that they grow to be big professionals. I like the fact that East Africa is now beginning to develop players that are good enough to play in the Premier League. You know, you've got Victor Wanyama from neighboring Kenya.
Yeah.
You've got Divock Origi as well, who, by
he's
all
Belgian,
intents and
purposes,
he's Belgian. But you know, his dad played for the national team of Kenya. You know,
yeah.
So he is, for all intents and purposes, Kenya. I think that's what Uganda needs to do now: grassroots football, get people who are serious about the sport, and let them build people. You know. You can catch a child at 6 years old, you know, and catch a star at 6 years old.
All right.
So I think that's the way to go. But well done to the Cranes.
All right. Well done to the Cranes. Of course, he talks about East Africans who are starting to make it to the big money leagues. We have one that, of course, has a deal that has just been announced. Looks like the new migration is the rest of the world to China. And
yeah.
Kenyan striker Olunga
yeah.
Completed a deal to newly promoted Chinese Super League team. So, yeah, that is the Africans
yeah.
or the East Africans getting to go out there. But in terms of the game, have you managed to watch the Uganda Cranes play?
I've listened to the commentary. So the BBC World Service is running the commentary on radio. And because I've been traveling in the last week or
yeah.
you know, so I've been listening to the commentary online. So I haven't really watched the action. But you know, back home, I told my son to record every single AFCON match for me, and I'm going to go home and watch it.
All right, I hope you will have yourself a great time.
Yeah,
now let's talk about the Africa Cup of Nations itself. Before we do that, we do have a bit of a clip from the coach Micho and of course the captain Geoffrey Massa getting to have a word about the Africa Cup of Nations so far. Let's have a listen to that, then we'll get back and we'll talk to Peter here about what the Africa Cup of Nations has gotten us to offer and what has gotten to offer to us and what exactly has caught your eye. For now, Micho and Massa.
We must improve and bring ourselves in position that one ball. Football is very tricky, unpredictable game. It's turning up and down. We want to do anything possible that in last game against Mali, that one ball or balls are turning in our favor and making us going with head high back home.
We went to finish on high. We went to play as a team. We went to win that game. We don't care what Mali went. We also went to win the game and go home happy. I think we're gonna approach the game on the same attitude, the same character, the same discipline, because we want to win. We also want to win on Wednesday.
As professional coach, I'm fully focused on the 90 plus minutes in the match against Mali. All other things are very much possible and open. Coaches' bags are always half packed, ready to stay, ready to go. I have a million and one reason to stay, because World Cup dream is there, and we have shown against Ghana and Egypt that we are capable of taking the team to Russia 2018.
The national team coach and the national captain, that is of course Micho and Massa respectively. Now, Peter, when we were starting this conversation about the Africa Cup of Nations, you were telling Ugandans to be appreciative of the fact that Uganda are the Africa Cup of Nations, Zambia are not, South Africa are not, Nigeria are not, Angola are not. Mm-hmm. I keep saying that the pendulum of African football superiority seems to be swinging. The Cape Verde might not be at the Africa Cup of Nations this year, but they too have put in results in recent times that have been very, very impressive.
I mean, look at Guinea-Bissau at the Nations Cup for the very first time. Mm-hmm. I mean, it just goes to show that football has got nothing to do with the size of your country or how wealthy your country is. It's just got to do with a lot of commitment. I know luck plays a part sometimes, but you've got to be committed to earn that luck. And like you said, you know, the pendulum will swing. You know, I mean, who would ever believe that if you're talking about wealth, South Africa or Nigeria would never be at the World Cup? You know, they've got the money for the best training facilities, but if you are not committed, mm-hmm. how can you get there? I mean, look at the debacle that happened with the Nigerian girls mm-hmm. after the Women's Africa Nations Cup. You know, they won the trophy in Cameroon, mm-hmm. went back home and were expected to be paid their bonuses. Now, they were not asking for anything too much, but the salaries they were owed for the work they had done, mm-hmm. they weren't paid, and then they went on strike. It took the president's intervention for these girls to be paid. How do you run football like that? You know, so those are the problems.
All right, and these are some of the federations that have had a whole lot of money get Absolutely. To be invested in the sport. Now, which countries have caught your eye?
Well, you know, I mean, I'll talk about the countries that are appearing at the Nations Cup for the first time. You know, so the Cranes, like I said, you know, congratulations for you. You know, just realize that this is something that you should build on. Mm-hmm. Zimbabwe, they hadn't been there for a long time. Mm-hmm. Guinea-Bissau, first timers there, you know. Right. And, I mean, and they've all acquitted themselves quite well.
Okay, that is a little bit of course, what has caught Peter's eye. We're going to be talking much more about the Africa Cup of Nations. We are going to be talking as well about African stars in Europe later on in the show, but that will be after this break.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.